world changed forever. AI world is just getting crazy every single time. This couple of weeks has been outstanding. OpenAI event opened the conversation at the beginning of last week.
GPT-4o provides GPT-4 level intelligence, but it is much faster and it improves on its capabilities across text, vision, and audio.
Definitely that event was very, very delightful. I think you can enjoy a lot all that content, all the different possibilities that 4o is bringing to our lives.
Think about what operation would undo multiplication.
Is it subtraction?
Close, but think of the opposite of multiplication, because 3x means 3 times x.
Okay, I think it's division. Let me try to divide both sides by 3 and let me see what I get.
Bingo! Go ahead and divide both sides by 3.
Okay, so ChatGPT, this is what I ended up with. How does this look?
It looks perfect. You've solved it, and x equals 1.
And this is just starting rolling, it's free. That's a lot of very good things. We have then the interview with Sam Altman that I think has been outstanding. Definitely what is the second big topic during the week.
I think there will be like Sam and Sam's AI assistant. And also I want that for myself. Like I don't want to feel like this thing is just like this weird extension of me, but that it's a separate entity that I can communicate with across a barrier.
Sure, I think interesting approach, how the agents will behave in the future, just representing us with all the different emails, communications, and improve our productivity, because we don't need to be all the time being in touch with all these things. Our bot, our assistant, will do that work for us. So, and in the sense, this bot knows us very well, it is us. It's just an extension of ourselves. The second piece of the week was Google event. A lot of tools around all the technologies and pieces and everything that Google is doing to achieve the AI world. Very interesting. And I think the 4th activity on the week that is the big ones was OpenAI, Google, and then this interview that all the CEOs shared their thoughts. And Emily Chang, I think, shared a very good human perspective, how the Google is envisioning all this process.
How much do you worry about becoming a dinosaur in a world where technology is moving so quickly?
In technology, I think if you don't innovate to stay ahead, I think that's the inevitable fate of any company.
Then we jump into Microsoft presentation that starts yesterday and it will continue today. And as part of the journey, they are sharing the vision, once again, into chapters, how the company is envisioning the process and definitely Copilot and all the hardware that can support the Copilot properly is just great. It will increase our productivity by far, because our PC will behave as we expect.
There's recall, which is the ability to just remember everything you've ever done on your computer, anything you've seen. If you're looking for a specific dress in Pinterest, it'll remember what you were looking at weeks ago, even if it was across different websites and different stores. It's a really interesting idea and an interesting use case of AI capabilities here. And it's really things like that Microsoft is pushing as Copilot.
The interview from Emily Chang again with Satya Nadella was just outstanding. I think it's very interesting how Microsoft is very focused, very understand what they need to do, and they're doing it.
We've always had CPUs and GPUs, and now you have neural processing units to, in fact, locally process these AI models. We have 40 plus AI models that are local. And of course, Copilot is built in to Windows, and Copilot is just not an app. It's sort of a shell affordance that's going to be there assisting you. AI is an assistant. AI helps you as an end user do anything.
And it's more coming. It's just the big event is just pending. There are very promising activities for Mac event in June. There are a lot of activities about Cisco, which is all the networking support. So it's just amazing. We are in the, I don't know, the most challenging areas in our lives, at least as I remember, maybe bigger than the internet access that was just incredible at that time. But right now it's just changing the world again with all these tools and productivity. What can you do about it? So that's, I think, two perspectives. One is how this is changing our everyday life. And as a human beings, we need to be in top of that conversation just to realize how to do all the things better. But it's also a world change. And I think that's an interesting study that we can share. The link will be here, and I think a small presentation in a second. With this content, you can understand that LinkedIn shared a very nice approaches, all how the people are evolving, how the companies are evolving, and how to tie those together And then is when the new topic, which is what are we doing about sales? Sales is our main priority in S4DS. We really envision how to enhance sellers and people's lives. So regardless of your activity, as we have been sharing so many videos, if you work in a physical store, if you sell service, maybe in a call center, or maybe you go door to door to sell whatever you're selling. So regardless if you're independent or part of an organization, it's the same challenge. It's what are we doing to embrace this? We have a big challenge. Everything is happening right now. A lot of work can be very bad in the future, but maybe sales is the work of the future. That's what we envision. That's what we want to share with you. And all the tools that we're developing, and a lot of good companies are doing it too, is to help sellers' lives. First is how to improve the knowledge of the seller about the company, about the proposition, everything that you need to hardly know to represent what you do properly. Two, you need to understand and be the expert in the portfolio you're sharing, regardless of your activity, service, product, anything, you need to be that seller representative that everybody loves. Three, you need to go to the in top of the customer. You need to know the customer, make a customer query, understand all the history, what they need, what is the categories they prefer, how to move faster, because that productivity is important. Then the fourth one is how to do that with automatic and instant action. You need to place an order, enroll someone, update the customer information, create a note, create a pending activity. Whatever you need to have it in your fingertips just in seconds. You cannot wait longer, or just, I will call you later, or come back tomorrow. That's not anymore possible. You need to change your thoughts. You need to change your tools. You need to train yourself in another way, because time is restricted and you need to be productive. So we're in the top of that conversation. We really want to share with you all this experience that we're trying to grab. There is a lot of interesting points. So just let's work together. That's, I think, what we want to bring today. All this summary about all these trends and big events and great interviews, how to understand those and to grab the best in terms of putting it in our timeline, in terms of our sales groups, how it can be better. So thank you so much for joining, and hopefully you enjoyed this content.